Game 2 ng New York Knicks at Miami Heat. Jimmy Butler is out and Randle is back for the Knicks. Obviously, the upper hand will go to New York, but this is not an easy task. Panalo ang Knicks 111-105. Jalen Bronson took the blame noong Game 1 and nangakong magiging better dito sa Game 2 as he drops 30 points. Kahit masakit yung kanyang paa, naglaro pa rin ito, playing through pain, but his mental is tough. Naging maganda din yung contribution ni Randle with 25 points, 12 rebounds, and 8 assists. RJ Barrett with 24 points. The Knicks team is really dangerous if yung tatlo is ganyan yung performance. Buti talaga, na-overcome ni RJ yung adversity na he is missing in action daw kapag playoffs. But for Miami Heat, without their leader, this is a tough one. Butler is averaging 35.5 points dito sa playoffs. According to Coach Eric, it is certain that they weren't able to find a way to win. Siguro, nagkulang lang talaga sa fire in the end. Tsaka yung clutch genes ni Butler is namimiss nila. For Knicks, nag-click yung tatlo, especially si Randle na nakapag-attract ng too many attentions. Kaya meron siyang 8 assists, leaving a lot of shooters. Kaya naging recipient si Josh Hart with 14 points. Good contribution for the Heat, pero mostly in the first half lang yung kanilang mga other players, especially si Max Strus na nagkaroon pa ng bruised lower back. Tabla ng series 1-1. Next, Game 1 ng Golden State Warriors at LA Lakers. This looks like the finals matchup na yun, no? Maybe the final battle of our generation, LeBron James versus Stephen Curry. Panalo ang LA 117-112. It was a battle of different approach. Lakers opted to head to the basket. They dominated the paint battle 54-28. As for the Warriors, tatlong players ang merong anim na 3-pointers, Steph, Klay, and JP. Pero best game ni AD in the postseason so far, 30 points and 23 rebounds. First Laker after Shaq na merong 30 and 20 game. Yung focus ng defense ng Lakers is on the shooters. Lagi silang nagsasag kapag nakapasok sina GP2, sina DiVincenzo. Hindi rin nagkaroon ng third quarter outburst yung Warriors na kapag nakuha nila to yung quarter na to, mataas yung chances nila to win the game. Lakers able to create more separation in the third alongside Austin Reeves and D'Lo caught fire. Meron pa namang 14-0 run yung Warriors in the end para maitabla yung laban under 2 minutes. Grabe din yung free throw disparity. Lakers with 29 attempts and Warriors only have 5. Pero ayun nga, nag-focus kasi yung Lakers on attacking while Warriors with their usual game bombing from the outside. Jordan Poole had a pretty good game, pero bakit naman ganun yung decision making sa dulo? I would have rather to have Kevon Looney inside. I don't know, but he shoot a deep three with a lot of time remaining and kita natin yung frustrations ni Curry, some of the players, fans. I don't know bakit. Good shot syempre kung pumasok, kaso not a matured shot. Yung mga ganong tira, you're gonna live and die with your best player kahit ganon pa kalayo or mas malayo pa yung attempt. Eh si JP, ilang games natin nakikitang parang wala sa wisyo, ano ba yung nasa isip niya? Ano mo yun? And the officials give the Lakers the timeout kahit nagbabattle sila for a possession. And Warriors didn't contest that one. Kasi for me, akala ko it was a jump ball na to have another chance of an attempt. Pero ayun, congrats Lakers. Kayo ba? Anong tingin nyo sa deep three ni Jordan Poole? Let me know all your thoughts in the comment section below. I will now step back. Bye-bye.